are fully capable of deciding your own destiny. The question you face is, which path will you choose?
Welcome back to the vlog. I decided to come to school with Jeffrey today so I can get some work done. I don't know if I'm going to get any work done because Jeffrey's class today is a running and jogging class and they only have to walk or jog 0.5 miles and it's probably not going to take more than like 10 minutes. So I'm contemplating if I even want to walk all the way to the lab because it's cold outside. First of all, I figure why not just go since I'm already here and Jeffrey can probably just meet me at the lab. There's this one assignment that I keep pushing back and it's definitely this essay that I need to finalize. I was going to finalize it Tuesday, but I never did because I just didn't want to do it, but it's a really, really simple essay. There's really no right or wrong answer to this essay. It's mainly just about like my personal life and my dream job. I haven't had coffee or any food in my system, so I might go get some Starbucks at our Starbucks cafe. I really need some energy right now. We were kind of in a rush to get here on time for Jeffrey's 10 o'clock class. Yeah, it's currently 9:46. I will see you guys there whenever I get my Starbucks order. Freezing!
And I don't wanna be lonely when winter is freezing and trees start to bolt. And I don't wanna be sitting alone in a room that's just filled with my soul. And so I came to this place, I'm looking for a familiar face, and that's when I saw you.
I am so stuffed. We just finished eating lunch and I made some red Thai curry last night. So we ate that again for lunch today. Update about Jeffrey. He is doing okay. I just think that he felt very nauseous because he didn't have anything in his system and he hasn't really done any cardio workout lately. He's just been doing a lot of lifting. We were sitting in the library for a few minutes while he was like trying to recover from his nauseousness, and then we came back home and ate, and he's perfectly fine now. By the way, he is okay. He's not sick or anything. He doesn't have COVID, so please don't go ahead and assume that he does. He doesn't. His taste buds are still there. I am currently right now about to film a few TikTok because I feel like I just been so behind on it. I have a lot of pre-recorded TikToks in my drafts. It doesn't hurt to film a few more just to be prepared for whenever the time comes. So yeah, I wanted to show you guys my full list of TikTok reels ideas because as you guys know, I've been trying to grow my Instagram lately. I want to say that I actually have passed this goal of mine. So here is my goals and this is my journal. A lot of you guys were asking me where I got this and I actually got this from Home Goods. This is how my cover looked like. I decided to merge in like a bullet journal theme while also writing my journal entries in here. Like I said, I do have my goals on this page as well. I have my subscriber count goal, I have my Instagram follower goals, and then my views goals right here, and then how much I want to earn on Google AdSense, and then my journals. I want to say that I'm seriously so proud of myself for working so hard this month on trying to grow my social media platform. I just feel like I'm not growing as fast as I want to, but then that's another thing that I have to keep in mind, that I shouldn't be comparing my journey to someone else's. I just have to keep in mind that I need to keep working hard and not try to think about those thoughts, because when I'm thinking about those thoughts, I could be creating better content for you guys. I've been trying to not get on my phone as much, but social media is my full-time job, so it's kind of hard not to, if you guys get what I'm saying. So yeah, enough about ranting. Let me show you guys my list of TikToks and Reels ideas that I have jotted down. If you guys want to know how these videos turn out, make sure to follow me on Instagram and TikTok. Whenever I am filming a TikTok or a Reel, I like to sort of jot my ideas down. So the ones I already marked out, I already have uploaded and posted on my TikTok slash Reels. And then I sort of like to make an outline sometimes. I haven't written an outline yet, but sometimes I like to do that if it's like more of like an in-depth talk through video talking points, so I know what I want to talk about in that TikTok. I will catch you guys up whenever I am done with my TikToks and Reels. It's currently 3 o'clock right now, and I just finished filming about 5 to 6 TikToks, so I already have a whole batch of videos planned out for next week. I also finished taking some pictures for my Instagram, because as you guys know, I am trying to aesthetically organize my newsfeed and make it look pretty. I just wanted to show you guys a few pictures that Jeffrey and I took, because I wanted to get some pictures with him as well, because I realized that I don't really upload any pictures of us together on my Instagram page. I decided to make the pictures that we took a little bit more aesthetic, a little bit more mysterious, a little bit cute, minimalist. So as you guys can see right here, I took a whole bunch of random pictures, like a whole bunch of pictures that goes behind one photo that I want to upload. Later on today, we're actually going to go to Target. Also, I decided to take out the rubber bands out of my hair and just let it kind of roam freely, because I wanted to take pictures in a different hairstyle and then also have my makeup on. So that's another tip for you guys as well. If you guys are wanting to become like social media influencers, if you want to go ahead and have like a huge batch of Instagram photos ready to go, take a whole bunch of pictures, change up your hairstyle, do something different with your makeup, change your clothes, just have different backgrounds. That's like the number one thing I always do, because every time I put makeup on, I try to take advantage of how much pictures I can take in one day. But anyways, I'm getting off sidetrack. I got this oversized t-shirt from Shein, and I'm just wearing these PJs that I got from JCPenney's. Later, we are actually about to head to Target to go grab some snacks for Jeffrey, because like I told you guys earlier in today's vlog, he got sick. The weather here is a little bit bipolar. There are some days where it's warm, some days where it's cold, and some days where it's suddenly snowing. Funny enough, I actually went to Target the other day. I can't believe I'm going back, but it's like so therapeutic just going there. Like, I don't have to think twice about it, but I love going to Target. I am planning to paint my vase today. So let me show you guys the vase again, because I feel like you guys kind of forgot what I'm talking about. I don't think I'm going to be filming my room makeover anymore, just because I accidentally deleted a few clips, and I feel like I didn't really do anything major with my room, so I felt like I don't really need to upload it. But I will probably show you guys an updated room tour soon. The vase is the last thing I need to paint in order to have my room makeover sort of complete. Yeah, I'm going to do like this DIY ceramic faux vase and then put it at the corner of my room, because I already have my pampas grass out, as you guys saw in yesterday's vlog. Decided to paint, so I'm going to get everything set up now, paint it and let it dry, and then probably head off to Target. Yeah, they were definitely too short. I feel like I'm gonna have to go buy like a styrofoam so they can like stay up like this. Hopefully that makes sense. So this was like my ideal DIY vase with this pampas grass, and I feel like it's supposed to look cute like this, but I'm going to paint it and then see how it turns out. I just cut out this red cup and then got some baking soda, some paint, and a paintbrush. And all you have to do is just paint the surface. Leave me dry. You, baby, share a new life. All my life. Layer one of the vase is done. It actually coated really, really well with the baking soda. I'm probably gonna go in with a second layer once it fully dries, but overall, this is how it looks like, you guys. Really, really cheap DIY that you can do at home if you're not planning to drop about like $50 for a vase. It looks super expensive and it looks amazing. We just got back from Target and McDonald's because McDonald's came back with their spicy nuggets. But I think I'm going to go ahead and close out today's video just because Jeffrey's parents are coming tomorrow, and so that means we have to clean the place. Yeah, this is their first time ever seeing our apartment due to COVID and everything, you know, and so we want to just go ahead and clean for the rest of the evening. Just wanted to show you guys what I usually dip the spicy nuggets in, and it's with hot mustard. It's so good. Trust me, you guys, on this. I know today's vlog was a very, very short one just because of what happened with Jeffrey and everything like that. I really just felt the need to just take care of him for a while. I really hope you guys don't mind this super short vlog. Other than that, I will see you guys in my next vlog. Bye!
Was going to ride it on the road and shout it down till Montreal. Yeah, I knew when